So, Daniel, give us your thoughts as chairman of the Wolves 18770 Trust on the season tickets.
Really, really disappointed, Dave, with the club. I've not felt this low since we got relegated to League One. I think the club have really misread our fan base. They've misread the room. As a trust, we're calling on our season ticket holders to boycott the renewal process, because that's the only action available to us now where the club will actually listen to us. We made it clear that we didn't want a ticketing price increase. 6 years in a row now, enough is enough.
Hi, so I've just heard the excruciating rises in season ticket prices, and obviously probably match day prices as well for Wolverhampton Wanderers next season. Most mental health issues have finance as the contributory factor, where people struggle to pay and have to work long hours and they don't get a release from that cycle. And the club have decided to add to that trauma for that sector of people. It's not good enough that I can maybe afford a price or somebody else can. There's a huge sector of fans that rely on football for their release and to get away from everyday issues, and now they're being priced away from even attending those games. It's a sad state of affairs, you know. And the local person who has the affinity with the club, who, you know, bleeds this gold and black that we wear, is almost disregarded, and the club has to do better. It's a little bit shame on Fosun and the chairman and the people making decisions. You can't say you care and then do this. Appalling.
So, just found out that it's a 17% rise on season tickets. Am I surprised? No. Am I feeling happy about this? Absolutely not. Am I feeling smug about this owner? Very. There's only one way now for this lot, and that's out the door. Get them out.
Hi Dave, just seen the announcement about the huge hike in prices. I think it's a lot more than what we expected, and I think the timing of this is particularly bad given all the issues that have been going on with VAR recently. This is already ruining the fans' experience of football live in the stadium, and then to say that you're now going to be charged nearly 20% more for that privilege, I think is really bad timing. The main source of clubs' revenue isn't from ticket sales, it's from Sky. So why have this PR own goal of hiking the prices at this time? And I think other sources could be utilised better to raise money rather than using the fans as a cash cow.
Hi Dave. Hi everyone. Golden Girl here. Not impressed at all. Not impressed. I think the word that I'm going to use is extortionate. It's not fair on us. You know, we work bloody hard to go and watch those lads play football. That team means everything to the likes of myself, who don't really have hobbies in life. My life is the Wolves. And I can't see the justification in such an increase in... It's just beyond me, absolutely beyond me. I'm going to see whether I can move my seat. If I can't move my seat, then I'm going to have to pay. I'm going to have to pay you, but I won't be happy to at all. And Jeff Shee, if you're watching this, you should hang your head in shame.
So the season ticket prices have been announced, and I'm going to be honest, I'm not very happy. I just think that for the money we're paying, the signings we're making, the football we're producing, and what the future of the football club is. It's not worth it. Man City season tickets for my age are £725. So I'm paying £110 more for a Wolves season ticket. Do you really think that we're better than £110 like Man City are? I'll let you think about that one.
Hi, Dave. Boston Brian here from Southampton. I'm an old git in the upper steeple stand, and I've just found out that my increase is 22.28%. I think the kids are even going to be even more. I'm going to have to give this some serious thought because, as you know, I live in Southampton. It costs me a lot of money to get there. Youth travel, you know, train, car, petrol, diesel, whatever, you know. Then the cost of coming to a game anyway, which is food as well. This is maybe the straw that breaks the camel's back. I'm going to have to give this a lot of thought over the next few days, whether to renew and just go on a ad hoc basis.
So 17% increase on season ticket. Didn't expect it to rise from 625 to 735 for this season. A push, I'd have accepted 680, 670 max. It's not fair, it's not right, and it's only going to start pricing people out and lose our core base of fans. And I fully expect Mr. Jeff Shee and Fowson to get a lot of heat this season off the back of this, as well as statements that he's released this morning about, if you don't like it, shut up, essentially.
Season ticket prices, Dave, I wasn't expecting that. We all knew there was going to be an increase, but they were just way out of line with what I think a lot of people expected. Bearing in mind the cost of living crisis we've got at the minute and fans being the lifeblood of the club. We've already got VAR, which is stretching fans' patience to the absolute max, and obviously now this. You know, I know, I understand that a price has to be paid for Premier League football, but it doesn't seem in line with the other clubs neither. So it's really disappointing. I think they're you know, bargaining on the fact that they think fans are going to renew because they're loyal to, but for some people, they just can't afford it, you know, and it's awful. It really is a sad state of affairs.
Hi, Dave, mate. Yeah, it's not a very good day to be a Wolves fan, is it? The season ticket prices, they've been raised so much. And for me, it's uncalled for because I don't think it reflects where we are as a football club at the minute, to be honest. It's our lowest finish since coming back to the Premier League in 2018. So I don't understand how it's took such a drastic raise. I think they're comparing us to teams who are constantly in Europe or a London team for how much they price the fans to renew their season tickets. So I think they're wrong on, I think their judgment's wrong on that one. They're pricing out the fans that are diehard Wolves fans, and that's what creates the atmosphere at Molineux. And I think that's really what pushes the team on. I think we're better at Molineux than we are playing away, so it's going to have the effect on the team. So a lot of people's love for the club would shine through, and they'd renew their season ticket. But yeah, it's really unfortunate. I'm with everybody else on it. I think it's inexcusable. I think it's inhumane as well, especially with the situation the country's found itself in with the cost of living. So yeah, it's really unfortunate. It makes the mental health video seem a bit ironic now. But yeah, what can you do?
Hey Jeff, thanks. £835 to sit in such a luxurious steeple stand next season. God, thank you from the bottom of my heart. It's really kind of you. You know, I mean, Villa up the road, what were they doing? Just hiking their price up by 5% and they're delivering Champions League football. Idiots. Yeah, you milk us dry. You do it. Yeah, and, you know, maybe don't bring any players in again and just keep that squad wafer thin. And maybe, who knows, we could lose Gary O'Neill as well, another good manager, you know, following Lopetegui out the door. Yeah, let's you keep at it, Jeff, because at the moment you're running this club into the ground. And you know what? The quicker that Fosun look in the mirror and go, we should sell this club, I think the better it would be for everyone. Because at the moment, you're going to be losing a lot of fans. Thanks, Jeff.
Really disappointed to hear about the ticket price increase, obviously. Disappointed, but actually not that surprised. I think things have unfortunately been going downhill for quite a while. If you look at the quality on the pitch, quality, you know, the environment, you're being charged now premium prices for what is actually a substandard product. And I think, unfortunately, in other walks of life, you wouldn't put up with it, but the club know they've got you where they want you, really. You're not going to go elsewhere. So, yeah, really disappointed. It's not even about whether you can afford it now, it's about whether you see it as value for money. And I think after going for, you know, well over 30 years, it's just a real shame that, you know, that's something you have to consider now when trying to support your football club.
Well, I've got to say that the club's one-pack mantra has been really punched straight in the gut and ripped out the soul with these price increases, not least for disabled and young people, of whom their increases have been well above inflation, to say the least. It will have a detrimental impact on fans and supporters. Myself and others on the club's Equality Advisory Group are seeking answers as quickly as we can. And it really is a... it's a really a huge blow to a lot of people.
Integrity is an important word, isn't it, in business? Integrity and honesty. Doing what you say that you're going to do. When Fosun took over Wolves, the promises made were incredibly ambitious and very, very exciting for the fan base. We've seen the watering down of those promises to the point now where you wonder whether there was any real substance behind them. Because yesterday's news about the season ticket hikes, and I hope that they've got in that boardroom the Dick Turpin masks that they really should be wearing now. I don't trust this bunch of dishonest people. I don't trust one word that Jeff Shee or Fosun Group say. And in particular, the price hikes to the children and disabled at Wolverhampton Wanderers is nothing short of absolute disgrace. So Jeff, if you're listening, up yours, mate, because Black Country people don't forgive this sort of behaviour easily. You might get a couple of thousand people on your waiting list renew where the people don't, but you'll never get back the trust, you'll never get back the love of the fans. You and Fosun are finished, no matter what you do. So, up yours.